This is Sushant. Today we are going to talk about how to calculate body fat percentage. I have talked about what body fat percentage is in my previous video, and I said that I would post about how to calculate it in my next video. So here this video is. So I'm going to be talking about five methods which can be used to get an estimate of your body fat percentage. Starting with the first, which is DEXA scan. It is basically a scan which you can get done in some any hospital. They would pass some rays through your body and they would give you readings of your body fat and the amount of fat in your body, the amount of muscle in your body. It is one of the most accurate methods out there to get your body fat percentage. It tells the body composition, so it might tell you that this hand, your right hand, has a little more muscle than your left hand, which can answer the question that you have always been feeling that your right hand is stronger than the left hand, kind of a thing. It tells you which body part has how much muscle and how much fat, kind of thing. But the main problem with this is that it might not be available in every city or village. And second thing is that it is very expensive. It might cost you 5,000 or 10,000. So basically, it is not easily approachable for common men. If you are a rich guy and you live in a big city, then you might use this method. It is quite accurate, but for a common man, it is not feasible. Second one is underwater weighing, which is a method in which they will dip you in the water and they'll see how much water got displaced and how much force the water applied on your body, kind of a thing. And then they'll do some calculation and give you an estimate of your body fat percentage, your body fat levels. It is closely accurate to DEXA scan. They both are considered the best accurate methods amongst all the methods currently available for body fat, for checking body fat levels. But again, this is not easily available in any small city or town or village, and it is not cheap. It might cost you 2,000, 3,000 or maybe more. I don't have much idea on its pricing, but it is not cheap. That's what I know. It must be in thousands, not hundreds. I'm talking in rupees, Indian rupees. Now, third one is bioelectrical impedance machine, which is also called body fat monitor, which you can search on internet if you want to buy one. So these are these type of machines which you will hold in your hand. First of all, you'll enter your readings, your age, height, body weight, and then you'll hold it in your hand and you'll press the start button, and then it will pass current through your body. A mild current, you will not feel it, so don't be afraid about the current. A mild current in your body, and after 7 to 10 seconds, it will give you an estimation of your body fat percentage. So basically, it is not so much accurate. It is a bit less accurate. It will give you an error of 5 to 7%, or maybe more. So if you are at 10% body fat, and it might tell you 15 or 17% body fat, and it is not. It is dependent on many factors. So if you are dehydrated or hydrated, then it will give you different readings. If you measure after exercise, it will give you a different reading. For me, it gives me a fat percentage of 7 or 8, even if I am at 14 or 15 after exercise. Belly fat, sometimes these sort of machines do not consider or do not keep a track of the abdominal fat. So basically, then again, it does not give you the accurate. And also, this might be a little expensive. I bought this one for 2000. It is Omron body fat monitor. Omron company's body fat monitor. You can search it on the internet. But it can be used to track progress. So for example, I am on a fat loss diet and today I measured my body fat percentage was 15% on this one. Well, let's say I wake up in the morning, I don't eat anything and after getting fresh, I don't eat or drink anything and after getting fresh, I measure my body fat levels on this and it gave me a reading of 15%. My body fat might be 12% or and it might be giving me 3% more in the reading, but let's say it gave me 15%. And 1 month later I lost 3 kgs of body weight. Now I'll change the reading of my body weight in this and then I'll again hold it and measure my body fat levels. Now if it tells me that my body fat level is 13%, maybe my body fat percentage is now 10%, which used to be 12% 1 month back. But it gives you an idea that the body fat levels are now dropped by 2%. So basically, you can use it to track progress relatively. But make sure that you, every time you measure through this machine, you are in the same environment or same condition. So for example, waking up in the morning, not eating or drinking anything and after getting fresh. So, or maybe if you want to measure it later, maybe after you had your lunch and you had some water, then you measure it. But it doesn't make much sense for me to measure after exercise because it gives very different readings after exercise. And I told you that I got this machine for 2000. So it is also a little expensive for a common man. Now the fourth one in the picture is body fat caliber. These are body fat calibers. What you do with them is that you'll pinch your skin in them and they'll tell you the thickness of the skin. You do not do it on this area. You usually do it on the belly area, belly section. Or there are calibers who can be used for, to measure the thickness of the skin on chest, thighs, back or arms. So what it does is, this one is used on belly section. So what it does is it will see the thickness of your body part, the skin on the body part where you're measuring. And then let's say my skin came out to be this much thick on my belly. Now there is a measurement over here which tells you that the skin is this many millimeters. Now along with this caliper comes a chart. So looking at this chart, tells you that if you got let's say some reading on this caliber and your age is this much, then your body fat percentage should be approximately this much. For example, if I'm 25 years and let's say this caliber gave me a reading of 15 on my belly section, so it told me that the thickness of the skin on my belly section is 15 millimeters, then this chart says that I should be about 15.4% body fat. This is not completely accurate, but it is more accurate than this one. And these calipers are not so expensive. I got this one for about 200 or 300 rupees. And a common man can afford it. And you'll need some time to know how to use it. You'll need some time and experience, but that is fine. So you can use it on different parts of your body, depending on how caliper, what caliper it is. It says that it can be used on belly section, and it will just estimate my body fat percentage using the belly section skin thickness. So basically, skin is not thick. Skin is thin, but skin has fat under it, so it is basically because of that fat it becomes a bit thick. So if you have a lot of fat, your skin will be thicker, and if you have less fat, your skin will be thinner. So that is about this. And out of all the methods that I mentioned, this one is the most accurate and affordable and handy. So this is not accurate, then DEXA scan or underwater weighing, they are more accurate than body fat calipers, but not everyone can afford it or find it in their cities. So this one can be used by a common man, and a lot of athletes or bodybuilders use this most of the times because they might not have enough money to get the DEXA scan done, or they might not be getting themselves dipped underwater every 15 or 30 days. And also you can use this bioelectrical impedance body fat monitor to track your progress. Now, a method I suggest for someone who doesn't have any of these methods is that you go on Google, search on Google body fat percentage, and go to Google Images. It will give you a lot of images which tell you that a person at 10% body fat looks like this, a person at 15% looks like this, a person at 25% looks like this. So you, and you know how you look in the mirror. So you'll get an idea that I am similar to this person, so my body fat percentage should be around the fat percentage mentioned for this person. Just to get an estimate, because you do not have any of these methods available. Females have a little more body fat naturally than males. So if you are a female and searching on Google for body fat percentage of female, so a person, a male having 20% body fat is kind of similar to a female having 27 to 28% body fat. Females have almost 7 to 8% more body fat, given that they have same fitness level on the basis of fat. So if I am a fit guy at 10% body fat levels, then a female who is similar or equal to me in terms of fitness on the basis of body fat, just the body fat, then she would be having a body fat percentage of about 17 to 18%. They might be so that this equating the fitness level is just on the basis of body fat levels. There might be a lady who is at let's say 30% body fat, and I am at 10% body fat, and she might be quicker than me, she might be stronger than me. So the comparison that I just mentioned was just on the basis of body fat levels. Usually females are on same fitness level on basis of fat are 7 to 8% more in body fat. So that is all about it. I usually use these two methods to estimate my body fat levels, and a lot of times I also use the third method. I see on Google a person who resembles my physique and what the, their body fat percentage is. Okay, so that is all about it. If you want to know which is the best method, I would say this body fat calipers and Google Images. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment box. If you like the video, please like it. If you like the channel, please subscribe it. And if you want to receive notifications for my future videos, you can turn the notifications on from this channel. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.